Hello there, it's Carrie Rhodes here. Welcome back to the Trinity Stamps YouTube channel. Today I am going to be making faux tie-dye backgrounds for my cards featuring one of the new stencil sets, Superstar, from the latest release. So we're gonna have lots of fun playing and making backgrounds with this stencil set. Here it is, it's two stencils. The stencil is approximately 6 by 6 inches. And you can see here there are openings for the stars as well as some etched stars. So you can layer the stencil over the top of what you already stenciled and line it up perfectly. So gone are the days of trying to mask off part of the stencil so you can have it one color and then another. These are also labeled A and B so you can kind of remember which stencil you were using. And also I like to keep that printed part in the lower left corner every time I stencil, then I know they're going to line up a little bit easier. I've taped stencil A to my 5 by 5, actually 5.5 by 5.5 inch piece of paper. And I'm going to use Kitsch Flamingo Distress Oxide ink and a blending tool to add ink to my paper. So I wanted to first show you how this stencil works because it's like, you know, the olden days are gone where now we have these layering stencils that you can line up with what you already stenciled. Like, it's just super cool. And I like to, you know, remember where we all came from with stencils and where we are now, because there's some pretty amazing things that these stencils will do. So now I have Salty Ocean I'm bringing in for my second color. And as I'm stenciling over this, like, I still have this sense of worry that I'm gonna get blue ink on my pink stars, but I can't because they're covered up, and it was really easy for me to line them up because of those etched stars. They lined up perfectly with the pink stars that I had already stenciled. Pretty cool, I'm loving that. So now I'm gonna have this background with 5 rings of stars, blue, pink, blue, pink, blue. Love it. So that's how that stencil works. But when we stencil, there's always this leftover ink on the stencil. So I'm spritzing this with water, and then I'm going to lay on a piece of cardstock and try and pick up that ink. So this is one way you can kind of create a tie-dye look, but it's very subtle here. So we're just going to keep playing with this, and I'll show you how I got more of an intense look. But I wanted to show you this way with the Distress Oxide inks, because you could do this with any ink pad that you have and a stencil. Now the tie-dye look works really well with these stencils because of their circular nature. So there is the blue one, and now I wanted it to be more intense. So I'm going to take my ink pad and just smoosh it right onto the stencil. So I'm not getting really 2 for 1 like I do if I stencil and then spritz the top of the stencil and pick up the pattern. I'm just going for a bold look. I spritzed it with water, and now I'm laying on my cardstock. So you can do this with any ink pad that you have, and then you get the part that's supposed to be colored, you know, the stars, is now a negative piece. So this looks pretty good for tie-dye. I don't mind that, but the best is yet to come. But still, we're gonna go ahead and do the blue so we can see how that looks in a different color, and spritz it with water first, and then you get those droplets. That really helps with the tie-dye look. And then once we peel this off, you can see how that looks. Pretty cool. And then I'm just picking up the excess ink randomly now, and I have like this half and half sheet of paper because I did the same with the pink. I don't like to waste any of my ink, and I love to make my own backgrounds, so this will go in my little basket of backgrounds to be used someday. All right, so let's try something different. I'm going to tape my 5.5 by 5.5 inch square piece of paper to the back of the stencil and spray it with Distress Oxide sprays. Now this is the magic. This is where it is going to really come to life as a tie-dye. So first I'm going to go ahead and create a stenciled background, but using the sprays instead of the ink and a tool. And then I'm picking up the ink on top with the paper. There's the tie-dye look that we're going for. Okay, so now I'm going to gently and carefully remove my paper so I don't get any ink like from my fingertips onto that background because I still want that to be nice. But I have all this ink left here, so I'm going to spritz that with water. This is the first time I'm spritzing it after using that distress spray, and pick it up with a piece of cardstock. And I've cut all these other ones down to A2 size, so this stencil works great on that too. So that's a more subtle background. Now I'm going to bring in the second stencil, and this also has the etched stars, so it doesn't matter if you start with stencil A or stencil B, they both line up with each other. And now I'm going to spray this with some worn lipstick. This is, it's not Kitsch Flamingo, but it's the one I have, so it's the one I'm using. And then I spritzed both of these, the blue and the worn lipstick, about 6 times. And after doing this, I realized that was just a little bit too much. Like, this has too much solid area. I want more white, but that's still a cool background, and I am gonna do something with that. So again, I'm going to very carefully remove that stencil so I keep a nice stenciled background, spritz this with water, if I can hold it still, and I'll make a second pull from this. And there you can see, very subtle again, but we can do something with that. And now I'm just gonna pounce on there and pick up color, and I have this crazy looking thing. I'm gonna do something with that too. So now let's compare these side by side to using the Distress Oxide pad versus the Distress Oxide spray. And you can tell what a difference there is there, but they're all still very cool. I really like them all. So, the magic is going to happen once you start making cards with these, you know? That's what's going to bring them to life. Sometimes we can just look at a plain background and overanalyze it. So let's move on and do this again, but this time I only sprayed 3 sprays. And look at that. Oh my gosh, it is so very cool. But I thought I went a little bit light. So I'm going to continue doing what I did. So I'm going to spritz this with water, pick up that excess, but I'm going to pick it up with one of those really light backgrounds that I had from the last time. Still, it's with the sprays, but look at that layered on top of each other. That's pretty cool. I love this look. So now I layered my stencil back on top of the one I already sprayed 3 times. I'm only doing 3 sprays this round, and then I'll pick that background up. And there you can see that one. Again, I really felt like it just wasn't enough ink spray. So I'm going to pick up the excess ink off of this with my blue one from the previous time. And then I'll have 2 layered backgrounds. And I think these are super cool looking like that. Okay, so I still have excess ink there, quite a bit. I'm gonna spritz that again, adding more water. And this time I'm gonna create an entirely pink background, just picking up all that excess ink. And this is how I made the background for this card right here. I stamped over the top of it, and it looked amazing. All right, so now I thought, let's make a background on top of one of those papers where I just picked up the ink randomly. This time I sprayed the stencil 4 times, and I think 4 is the magic number for me. That's what I liked. So I'm gonna pick up the excess ink by spraying this again, and I don't wanna waste that ink, so I'm gonna do this every time. So pick that up, and I try to just use my fingers to press it into the corners, and that looks amazing. Okay, so now I'm gonna layer the stencil over the top again. It was kind of hard to do on this one because it had a lot of things going on, but once I found a point I could line it up with, it was actually pretty easy. So I'll spray that with the blue spray, and I love how this one's gonna turn out with the ink smooshing underneath the stenciling. It's got that shabby chic or more grungy kind of look. And this one is my favorite. That's when I knew that 4 sprays was the magic number. But check this out, right? It's a pretty cool background. Okay, so we'll spray this. We're gonna pick that up. And that one's on one I already had created a pink background on. And I just like this look for tie-dye. I think this is the one I like the best for the mixed colors. Or maybe it's that one. Yeah, that's my favorite one. So I'm gonna show you all my favorites here so you can see just, I don't know, like how they look different. Every time you're going to get something different. And here's one, the one that had way too much ink with the 6 sprays. I stenciled over the top of it just with that 3-ring stencil. And I have white stars, I have pink, I have the blue. It's so cool. So don't waste those, stencil over the top of them. All right, so here are some cards. Now I made these cards after I'm going to show you a third card right here. I made this card with the stencil. That's what my original card was. And then I had all the ink left over on the stencils, so I decided to pick them up. And I made those as samples when these stencils very first came out from Trinity Stamps for samples on their website. Well, I really wanted to share with you how I made those backgrounds, but it's been a month or two since I made those, and so I kind of had forgotten how I did it. So that's why I was kind of experimenting with you guys today on this video and trying to recreate that look, because I just loved how it looked like tie-dye. So I am going to make a birthday card very similar to the Welcome Little Ones cards that I previously made for the samples, just really making a small focal point on this card so that the background is the star of the show, because I don't want to cover up too much of it. It's so cool. So I'm stamping and coloring and die cutting out that duck that's playing the drum, and then I die cut a circle so that he could sit on that and it would have something to ground him to the card, and then I glued the two together, and then I'm going to hide my glue on the back of that duck and glue the circle right to the center of my tie-dye background. And then I'm going to stamp some music notes from this set 3 times right around there, because I feel he's playing and probably singing Happy Birthday, which I'm going to stamp below that. I chose to do a birthday card because Trinity Stamps is turning 3, and so we're helping celebrate as a design team by sharing birthday card creations. So there's the birthday card and then the 2 previous Welcome Little Ones that I already did, and I hope that you really enjoyed seeing these tie-dye backgrounds, because I had so much fun. I couldn't stop making them. I can't even tell you how many I have now, like 25 backgrounds just from playing and making this video. I had so much fun. So let me know what you think in the comments below. I will be back again very soon with another video right here on the Trinity channel. If you want more inspiration, you can find Trinity on Instagram and Facebook too. I will have the products I used listed and linked for you below, and I'll see you all again very soon. Happy stamping. Bye.